Hey guys, Trishot Midget here, doing a kind of impromptu video. It's freezing cold out there. It's like 20 degrees, so I'm not going to be doing the overview out there. I'd rather do it in here. So, this is a customer's gun out of New York. He sent me, I think it was an HPA gun not that long ago, and I think that was built for outdoors. This one is for indoors. This flash hider on here is actually mine. He had nothing on it. I don't know if he runs a suppressor or something. Running a tracer, a small tracer, might be a good idea for this. For indoor, that'd be pretty cool. So if he doesn't have anything for the front end, maybe I'd recommend grabbing a tracer. The rail system on here is a URX style, which I really like, the Knight's Armament. So he has some rail covers on either side. I like those a lot too. One on the bottom would be nice. The rail is aluminum. It's got QD slots here and on the other side, as well as QD slots back here and here. That's pretty cool, that mount. That was all included. It has a front sight. The back one's missing. It has tri-rail on the front, as you can see. And then monolithic on the top. Metal receiver. It's in great shape. GMP. He said he just got this, but it, like, broke right away. GMP internals really are not very good. They're older ones. This was not one of the new ones. This is just the typical standard GMP gearbox. The hop-up is metal. I didn't change the hop-up barrel or bucking because it's an indoor gun and actually shoots pretty good. I'd recommend .25s, definitely indoor and out. If he does end up taking this outdoors, still use 2.5s. This is like the almost golf ball pistol grip. I recommend he get a different stock because you cannot access the battery compartment from the back on these GMPs. It's really stupid. These GMP stocks are dumb. Just dumb. You have to take them off every single time. He's still going to put the battery in the buffer tube. In fact, he's going to order two of these exact batteries. These are Nanotech 25 to 50C 1300 milliamp. So it's a higher C battery. So in terms of internals, it has a rocket, which is the same thing as the SHS high torque motor. SHS 12 to 1 gear, short stroke by two teeth, with a Matrix M110, which they just shoot hot. I was surprised. This thing was getting 370 with a .2 short stroke by one tooth, so I had to take it apart again. Other internals, it has a full cylinder by GMP, so maybe that helps get the higher FPS, but typically Matrix springs kind of just shoot hot anyways. I've learned that over the years. The trigger in here is a Jeftron, of course, specific, because they're proprietary, but they sell red ones that look exactly like a Retro Arms. SHS metal rack piston, it is the pre-lightened. I glued the rack down. I also glued the piston head screw in with a Retro Arms piston head. So really good quality parts. It's using the stock nozzle, which is aluminum, and it has an O-ring, so there's no reason to replace that. Stock tappet plate. I did cut the tappet plate spring, so it has more force for the nozzle. That's a typical modification for a high-speed gun. Also a sector chip on that sector gear, which I did cut as well, because sometimes they can be too big and hold the nozzle slash tappet plate back too long. So I cut it a little bit. That's kind of a habit that I always do, just because they're a little bit too big and hold the nozzle back too long. And it worked, of course, because I could toss any high cap in here and it'll feed semi or full auto all day. All right, so I just put it through the chrono with .25s. And it's shooting the goal FPS, so 325.3 is 1.23 joules with a .25. Because if you're shooting this low of FPS outdoors at, you know, 200 feet, 250 feet, you're trying to hit people. It's basically volume of fire, especially because a lot of people don't like to color hits. And a lower FPS gun, you got to have volume of fire. Hit them a couple times, they might cry, because that's a lot of airsofters for you. But just remember, you ain't hurting anybody with this. Trigger response is no problem with this. Leviathan's just truck. It was 32 rounds a second. That's pretty impressive. Fun. it shoots so well. He's gonna love this gun. As you can see, when I pull the stock off, it's just a mess back here. He really does need a bit. In fact, the charging cord for my battery is stuck on the stock. The little, if I can get it out, that little thing. So thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed this video. Again, he's going to pick up two of these batteries. They're 1300 milliamp, 25 to 50 C, and he's going to get a different stock. He's just going to have to find what'll fit it.